I know just.
I've done it.
Me and you are about to mix.
Looks like I'm here to stay.
Lava,
Moan.
Let's see what we found.
Thank you.
be a fight.
I...
Lava, beyond seek.
Right between the eyes.
Ready to brawl?
Could be a fight.
That dog won't hunt.
Yeah?
What's this? I'll be.
Please, I should rest and tend to my wounds.
Let's see what we've... I'll handle this.
Thank you.
when my hunters informed me that there was a disturbance in the crypt. I looked out over the water, and there it was, a sail, a ship. For that instant, it was as if my heart skipped a beat. You can appreciate the irony there, perhaps. I must assume, of course, that you have escaped from someone's dinner plate. Just so. How have you found Splintered Reef? It must make a curious scene to an outsider. A flock of gruesome puppets whiling away their lives in leisure. Decades of work undone by a Nazenale. I have few hobbies with which to fill these long hours, and now I am denied even this. I, who was second in command to the great captain, Lucia Rivan. Ach, until the day came that I was charged to perch here and maintain her forces until she should call upon me again. A century of waiting while she sailed freely upon the sea. E così. But why not enjoy my stay? I have crafted my own little empire. Do not think I have forgotten my duty. I gave dear Rivan a part in my little mythology. Our glorious founder. But it is my little paradise, and you have no part in it, but that of livestock. In part, I set my best people to the task. You may have met them on your way here. Briefly, it took some time to perfect the illusion that holds Splintered Reef together. A spell of enormous power, requiring a focus. The sphere, just there. You may have cost me valuable allies, but we have, all of us, been here a long time. I have others at my command. I need only summon them. E così? Free them? They are cannibals, people-eaters. Put a mirror up to that, and their minds will collapse. No person enjoys discovering that they are a monster. Ach, true. I began with different ambitions. Lucia Rivan desired an army to aid in her conquest. An army that would not succumb to injury or disease. Easy to say, but what to do with them all when they start to rot? Hard for any man to keep his senses when he begins to see the inside of his face. And so, my advisors devised a means by which to make these wretches unaware of their sorry fate.
Thank you.
I'm honored.
You did it! Look! I heard some strange noises. Took some time to work up the nerve, but I took the helmet off and I've kept me wits. You can't know what this means. I had a long time to get my head right. Figure out what I was, make peace with that. Maybe it'd be different if everyone else had the same chance. Not sure what I'll do now. At least I know for sure I ain't mad. Here, I don't need this thing anymore. Maybe it'll be some use to me. You mean it? Because I don't know if you thought this through. Hardtack won't do the trick with things like me. The sea! A real ship! Thank you, Captain. A more loyal sailor you'll never find.
sail all our troubles away. Hold fast to the helm, hold fast to the wind. Heave-ho, Empiente. Wondrous grace, for we'll all be skin as we sail down the dead fire way.
We've gone a long way, left our loves behind.
Heave-ho, Empiente.
It caused me a sorrow most unkind.
While crossing down the dead fire way, hold fast to the helm, hold fast to the wind. Heave-ho, Empiente. Wondrous grace, for we'll all be skin as we sail down the dead fire way.
They say in dead fire the luminous grows.
Heave-ho, Empiente.
And so that's where our brave ship goes.
To make our fortunes one fine day. Hold fast to the helm, hold fast to the wind. Heave-ho, Empiente. Wondrous grace, so we'll all be skin as we sail down.
The snow was on the ground. A sailor boy stood on the quay. His ship was outward bound. His sweetheart standing by his side had many a silent tear. And as he pressed her to his heart, he whispered in her ear,
farewell, farewell, my own true love. This parting gives me pain. I'll be your own true guiding light when I return again. My thoughts.
Thank you.
My sister returns grinning with accomplishment and speaking your name. Well done, outsider.
I will hear you, outsider. Tell Onikaza that the Wahaki accept her authority. If the time comes when she needs to show foreigners the breadth of her power, we will be there.
We said or not, Perrin.
I'd happily tell you if you stopped interrupting my count.
You've had days to count. Now it's time we talked about the price. We've had some complications. The price is doubled. Guess you've never snuck a few coppers from the tip jar. Let's just say there are other folks who'd be happy to pay my price. What's the point? I don't want to be in it long. I want to fill my hold with cash or retire early. There's plenty of business for enterprising sorts in Deadfire, and I have arrangements with every major power in the archipelago.
Had? Or don't you remember?
I'll remember this when I'm doling out rations tonight if you don't shut your mouth. I know they've got the cash. Fine. 1,000 it is. Glad we could do business.
Il Larde, 23 days. This is a new record. It is more than great. It is the successful test of my newest spell, Renove Miseris. Renewal of air, you would say? Kith have explored every mountain in the Eastern Reach, yet the realm of fish and leviathans remains close to us. It has been my dream to open these steps to discovery, to let Kith breathe as the fishes do. Or at least to let us use the air of a single breath again and again. Back home, they care only for profit, and there is little profit to be had in sticking your head in the glass bucket to watch the fish. But the Rauatians, they have vision. They chase greater things than gold. So I... Sientere, but I had promised not to say. Yes, I have much to do. Many more tests to run before we reach Sayuka. A pleasure talking, Captain. At last! I must go. Discovery awaits. Agrasima, Captain.
I shall.
Castall's lapdog. I trust you won't piss on the furniture. You found me with a rare spare moment. I've received a report from the Dockmaster stating as much. The Royal Deadfire Company appreciates your swift delivery of our cargo. Ah, that's unfortunate. Though not entirely unexpected. I've received a report from the Dockmaster stating as much. The Royal Deadfire Company appreciates your swift delivery of our cargo. Why would she? You're a courier. In any event... The Hazanui's missive suggested you might be able to help us with an issue at port. You may have noticed the outsized coral in the harbor. There's something unnatural about the coral's growth, about everything on this island. And no matter how we trim it back, it only grows larger. My engineers deduce that the origin of this disturbance is somewhere off the coast of Sayuka, and I'd like you to investigate. Talk to Avera in the workshop if you care to learn more. I would be grateful for your help here, Watcher.
You! This area is strictly off-limits to non-company personnel. What are you doing here?
Calm, amigo. Is this not the casito your Hazanui said she would send?
Praise be. The coral in the harbor is growing out of control, and we've found no way to stop it. We're at our wit's end. I've surmised that a magical disturbance must be the source of the problem. So far as I can tell, the most likely candidate is a strange magical signature emanating from some place off the southeast coast of the island, deep beneath the sea.
The Huanas records show that an ancient Anguithan ruin, Signath Mor, once stood at that approximate location. I do not doubt that something in that ruin is the source of the trouble. Perguono, take this. It is my masterpiece, Uck. The helmet should allow you to breathe underwater for time enough to deal with the disturbance, provided, of course, that you hurry.
The Royal Deadfire Company thanks you for your assistance, Watcher.
And your bravery. Aura Taugori!
But that doesn't make it sanitary. Tread cautiously.
I know, I've done it.
I have a feeling I'm not going to like what happens next.
Well, that sure helped.
What did you find, Ishii?
Watcher, still your hands. Signath Mor is under my protection. Why do you violate it? Indeed it is. The Angwithan's fine creation siphons essence from a vein of Adra deep within the earth, and the creatures of this region drink deeply of it. They grow strong, ruthless, and in so doing, worthy of my regard. Should you want to gain my regard as well, you would destroy this place to protect my machine. Then none will have the means to threaten my work here as you have. Cleverness should hunt always beside strength, Hound of Aethas. Because I am your god watcher, and I reward my loyal followers, you would do well to think twice before crossing me. You need only deactivate the three pylons scattered about the ruin. That will destroy the barrier protecting this place from the sea. You survived the trial of reaching this place. Surely whatever means allowed you to breathe underwater will serve you on your way back up.
Expertise.
This is futile!
Lava will be on siege!
What's this? I'll careful. I see them. It's done.
You were saying?
Ha ha!
I'll take care of this.
I see the wits of their eyes.
I'll take care of this.
how rare a thing it is, a Kith who does as they're commanded. The machine was unharmed, and will now remain so, thanks to your efforts. How bold you are to speak to your god thus. I must commend your bravery, and warn you too, do not overstep. You will not be Barath's creature forever. True loyalty requires a strength most lack, and you have proved yourself to be strong indeed, Herald of Barath. For that, I shall reward you. Take now my blessing, Watcher, and see with the keen eyes of beasts.
Parfito's never said a hard word as we sail all our troubles away. Hold fast to the helm, hold fast to the wind. Heave ho, Ensilente! Andra's grace, for we'll all be skinned as we sail down the dead fire away. We've gone a long way, left a long behind. Heave ho!
I hope your effort to resolve the Coral situation is meeting with success. I can't say I'm not disappointed. Now we'll have to make do without proper Coral defenses. We'll be vulnerable. People have cannons, Watcher. Before I forget, Atsura would like to see you at the Brass Citadel. Though he appears placid on the surface, Atsura is not a patient man.
Indeed.
See that?
Rush.
Isn't doing the job.
Not bad.
Let's see what we found.
Ishii, fly up there and crack open one of those bronze eggs.
If I don't survive our adventures, promise me you'll burn all my books.
I'll take care of this.
No. No! I watched you die, crushed under that castle. Your monument to hubris.
Hey, it's our little skull. We thought we'd lost you. You've grown so much.
Silence! I've suffered several lifetimes worth of your inane babble already. Again you interrupt my plans, and again I am forced to compensate. My days of bouncing in your shadow or being jostled among spears and daggers are over. This is the end of our sordid companionship.
Let's not fight. We just want our little skull back. The rest you can keep.
You will keep your hands away from me, cur. Whatever beginner's luck won you the day at Cragholt has expired. Fate brought us here to correct its error. One such offense was inexcusable. Your very presence. An abomination.
Rather cocky for a man with no skin.
Then I'll borrow some of yours. Describe a spell that shrinks ears. I see we've already descended to petty jabs. This should be over soon. If the Circle sent you to interrupt my research, I'll fashion a scarecrow of your remains to deter their next hapless victim. All a matter of perspective. The same thing, perhaps. But the Circle wants only knowledge. I desire the power it represents. They are fools to delude themselves into thinking they want otherwise. I'm sure that pig-headed Commander Baelorin is having a chuckle over the irony from whichever spoke of the great wheel he calls home. The Bannermen are loyal to a full purse, and my investments have paid off over several lifetimes. You would have done better to submit and wilt under my power. The things I do to you will make that end seem a gift.
That's not very helpful.
No. Lava, see that issue?
Hit me again and I'll hit you back.
Lava Ruby,
Lava Ruby on sea.
Thank you.
I'll take care of this.
Thank you.
is futile!
Lava,
you see that, Ishii?
Hey, watch it with that.
Onward!